Pfeiffer Me presents coverage of Planet Comicon 2017.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Matt Hentges with Sci-Fi for Me. We are streaming live from Planet Comicon here in Kansas City, and I'm here with some of the local R2-D2 builders. We've got Mike and Darren over here. So, Darren, we'll start with you over here. We've got this R2 unit, and this is something that you built by yourself, correct?
Yes. Well, I had some help with family members and stuff like that, and the club as a whole helps each other out a lot. If you have questions, you can always post on our forums and other builders will help you.
Sweet. So you guys have got forums and manuals and stuff to share the knowledge and sort of help each other along. What type of materials did you use for this R2 unit?
Mine is mainly aluminum. It has steel feet, but all the rest of them is metal.
Okay. And then what about the remote control, the moving mechanisms? What's all that? Is that stuff?
Mine is just it's this control right here, which is basically what some people use for like remote control airplanes and helicopters. And it's used to spin the dome and move them around a little bit and stuff, too.
Nice. Sweet. All right. And so how long did it take you to build this guy?
It took me about 4 years from start to kind of where he's at now.
Wow. That is commitment on your part. Good for you. All right. And, Mike, what about yours? Yours has got a little bit different finish. Is that on purpose?
Correct. You know, this one's built with different materials. It's got wood, styrene, aluminum, fiberglass, and some PVC. So it's a little bit of everything. So it looks a little bit different. This will be a fiberglass, so it doesn't have quite as shiny finish as an aluminum. But it's just different materials. Get a similar look and everything.
Now, he's moving, and I don't see your hands on anything. How is that possible?
Right. Right now, he operates on a simple wireless PlayStation 2 controller. And you can set him on an automatic setting. Just hit the select button, and he'll make random sounds, and he'll move his dome about a quarter turn each time. So I can just don't need to do anything with the remote. I can just set him to go, and he can just kind of does what he does right here, what you see.
Just set it and forget it, right?
Exactly.
So does he also roll, navigate?
Yes, he does. He does.
Excellent. Cool. And how long did it take you to build this guy?
2 years. 2 years to get it fully mobile, and then adding bells and whistles, such as a little kind of a lighted periscope and things like that, kind of came afterwards.
That is very impressive. The time commitment and the detail. These guys are so accurate to what you see in the movies. Now, do you guys have special names for them?
No. It's Mike's R2-D2, Darren's R2-D2.
All right. Well, yeah. Less points for creativity in that respect, but still, I mean, the engineering and the model and the attention to detail is just amazing. Thank you guys for sharing it with us.
No problem. Thank you.
Yes, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm Matt Hentges with Sci-Fi for Me. Check us out on Sci-Fi for Me TV on YouTube and on Facebook.